Hi, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. This is Jairam Rajaram, managing partner of Brill. Today, I am honored and privileged to have an extremely special guest with me. I have with me a family member. He's like family because he has been my spiritual guide. He has helped me establish my spiritual practice. I have followed him over the years because I have been fortunate that he has come home and stayed with me and my family. He's a very, 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 very dear person to me. He's like another father figure. I am so pleased to welcome Padma Vibhushan awardee, Sangeeta Kalanidhi, Mridangam legend, fellow Sangeet Natak Academy, New Delhi, Kalai Ma Mani, Dr. Umayalpuram K. Shivaraman. Mama, welcome to a Brill Talks episode. I am thrilled to speak with you.
So too, Amen.
Welcome to this show. Mama, let us start off this discussion with a bit about your younger days with your parents.
My younger days, I spent in Kumbakonam, where my father practiced as a medical doctor, and we belong to the ancient village, Umayalpuram, which I used to call very famous for culture as well as agriculture. More than that, this Umayalpuram village as a holy pass, in the sense that the connection of Umayalpuram with music is something phenomenal, and it is also legendary, in the sense two of the greatest disciples of the greatest bard, one of the trinities of music, that is the most revered Mahaguru and preceptor, that is Saint Tyagaraja. They are the direct disciples, the two, Umayalpuram Krishna Bhadar and Sundara Bhadar, and they were with him, and they had the benign, greatest blessing from the saint, and learned music under his holy feet. Not only that, they propagated the kritis of Saint Tyagaraja, which is known as the Umayalpuram Bani. And they created a legacy of greatest musicians. And even now, they are following the Umayalpuram Bani, which is also very famous. Other Banis are there. Among the other Banis, there are 3 or 4 Banis. Umayalpuram Bani is said to be very, very authentic and also very methodical. And they did it as a mission in their life. So, the same way Saint Tyagaraja lived in Thiruvayur by doing all his worshipful prayers to Lord Rama and doing every day the Munchavarti, the brothers of Umayalpuram, they also till their death, they also conducted the same Munchavarti in the streets of Umayalpuram and taught the same divine music to all the disciples. And the thing is that many of the disciples of these great brothers, they blossomed into very greatest musicians in the world of Carnatic music. For example, Umayalpuram Panjabi Keshav Bhavadar is a disciple, Bangalore Nagarathramal, and Balaram Krishnappa, and then Chaudhya sir, and Narsayya, and so many people. And my grandmother has told a lot of things about these people, because when they are a very eminent set of greatest disciples, namely Umayalpuram Panjabi Keshav, and another was the disciple of Punjabi Keshav was Malakkottai Gunasamy Pillai. He is a disciple of Punjabi Keshav. And they propagated through that disciple, Punjabi Keshav, and they had a lot of disciples. So the Umayyad Varma legacy started with Punjab Keshia and then Bangalore Nagaratnamal. Then Balaram Krishnappa, Chavadaya sir, Narasayya, like that. And they propagated all these things to several disciples. And the Umayyalpuram Bani became very famous in the sense Govinda Swami Pillai, who was one of the legendary violinists, was the disciple of Punjab Keshia. And Chavadaya sir, the great wizard of violin, he has told me a lot about the greatness of Punjab Keshia because the violin techniques and music from Punjab Keshia. And he once told me, Shivanama, do you know the great Punjab Keshia of Nyaval Pram, who is my guru, like that. Not only that, and they established, and there was an invitation from the Maharaja of Mysore, inviting these great brothers to Mysore. They don't generally go out of Umayyalpuram, but since the invitation came from Mysore Maharaja, they came, and there is a photo where Sundar Bahadur was wearing turban along with a disciple, and there is a photo is there. That means the connection of Umayyalpuram brothers with the Mysore royal family. And like that, why I'm telling you is not only in music, but in also in rhythm also, in laya. In laya also, Umayyalpuram is famous for the greatest gadam artist, Vidwan, Mahavidwan. Umayyalpuram Narayan Samir was a very great asset to Carnatic music, and he accompanied very great Mahavidwans in those years, like Mahavidyanadiyar, Patna Subramaniya, Sarvashashya, and all that. And there is a photo is there where Umayyalpuram Narayan Samir, he accompanied, and he went to Ramanathapuram Samasthanam, and the king invited him. There is a photo where he is sitting with Garam, with great musicians like Mahavidyanadiyar, Patna Subramaniyar, Mridangam great, Narayan Samyappa, and Narayan Sami is there, violin is there, some great violin Vidwan is there. Why I'm telling you, that is one aspect. The other aspect, with regard to that, in Same Vedam, Umayyalpuram is considered to be very, very a great village, which really has lot number of Same Vedis. In fact, the great Avatara Purusha of Kanchi Math, Paramacharya, was very much keen to hear the Samaveda of Umayyalpuram.
Wow.
If somebody goes to, from Umayyalpuram, or if he is going to be there in Kumbhakonam or somewhere there, for some camp and all that, he will say, "Yanda, in such a way, he was taking lots of blessings and giving a lot of blessings. And he knows the value of Samaveda of Umayyalpuram. Because I am also a Samavedi. That is why I am telling you.
Fantastic.
So this is a connection of Umayyalpuram, from where I hail.
Lovely.
And my father.
Yeah, that was, Mama, I'm coming to the next question.
Wait.
Yeah.
So, what really happened was, when the holy brothers of Umayyalpuram, they were doing the Uchavarti, our house, my paternal great-grandfather's house and maternal great-grandfather's house, they were all in East Street, Kedathari Umayyalpuram. So, there is a Bhajanamadam there. So, when the holy brothers will come for Uchavarti, they will stop in my great-grandfather's place, and my great-grandfather, that is, his name is Shivaramakrishnaya, after whom my name is there. I am named like after my great grandfather. So my great grandfather Shivarami will come and they will say and they will sing this particular thing. Krishnam Kalaya Sagi Sundaram Bala Krishnam Kalaya Sagi Sundaram. This Pundarikam will be there. They will give some Pundarikam and all that. They will sing the song and they will be there. And my grandmother, that is my father's mother, used to worship these people and put Akshata. So my grandmother Savitri Ammal, that is my father's mother, she has told me how the holy brothers, Krishna Badar and Sundar Badar, will look like. Because I know all these things I heard from my grandmother. And my father also told me, because he is very young. But my grandmother told me a lot about all these things. Why I'm telling you, such is the holy place from where I took birth and in a holy family, which really had a lot of philosophical, connection, a lot of spiritual connection, a lot of this bhajana connection. And they were all having a lot of Vedic connection. Such is the greatest family to which I belonged from Amyalpuram.
Lovely. Mama, the next question I'm going to is, what kind of influence did your father have on you? How did he nurture your talent? How did he identify your talent and nurture it?
In fact, before my father, I should give the greatest credit to my grandmother, Savitri Ammal, that is my father and mother. Because my father told me, and my grandmother told me, and also my mother, when I was born, when I was about 1 year old or something like that, I used to play anything like and tap on anything that comes to me, to my hand, and play something like that. So my mother, my father, and my grandmother, I think they saw some sort of a spark for this laya, oriented, probably the spark in me. And then one day at the age of 3, my grandmother Savitri Ammal purchased one ganjira from Kumbakonam, Kumbeshwara Swami Koil, and then gave it to me. In fact, I can say, I will say with pride, and I will say as a homage to my grandmother that she initiated me at the age of 3 into the world of rhythm. So my father was practicing in Kumbakonam as a medical man, doctor. So many people will come to my house. And when my whole house is saturated with music, my father also learned music. He learned violin. When he was in the medical college, he learned violin from Omayalpuram Venkatrama Iyer. He belongs to there, but he is known as, since he lived in Madras, he is known as Adam Street Venkatrami. That is Adam Street in Mylapore. But he belongs to Omayalpuram. He taught violin to my father when my father was in medical college. And later on, my father learned vocal music from one of the greatest Mahavidwan, Kolkata, Raghavacharya, who was one of the greatest disciples of the legend, Namakkal Narasimhangar, and a contemporary, Raghavacharya is a contemporary of Ariyakudu Ramanujangar. So, my father used to learn, and my whole family is very much interested in music and everything, and spiritual outlook and all that. And my great-grandfather and grandfather, they are all deeply, they know Samaveda. They know everything. So my father, my grandfather, so 2 years, at the age of 4. So at the age of 4 or something like that. So my great-grandfather taught everything to my father. So everything is in the gene. So my father used to sing and all that. And when I was playing all these things in Kumbakonam, whoever comes and sings, I will be playing something like that. So, and he saw there is some innate talent in the fellow. Why not we develop all these things? And he was really looking for one of the great gurus In fact, he wanted to approach, and he approached one of the Mahagurus, and I should say he is the Pitamaha of Maranga, Tanjar Vidyanadhirwal. And he approached him, and Vidyanadhirwal told him, "Doctor, this fellow is a small fellow. When he is, say, about 7 or 8, 9, you can bring all these things. Because my second guru was in Tanjavur. But whatever it be, only what I should say, my father was looking for one very good guru with the best of fingering and best of nada in Kumbakonam. But I want to tell you one thing. In my life, everything is providential. Everything happens by the benign blessings of providence. Why I'm telling you, I'll tell you. So when my father was looking for a great guru to teach me Mridangam, one client came to my father, and he had a carbuncle, and my father operated on him. And then my father was looking for one Arabadi Nadeshia. He was trying to find out Arabadi Nadeshia. But this gentleman came, and my father did this procedure, and he was all right. And then he asked him, "What is your name? What is your profession?" And he said, "I am Arabadi Nadeshia. I am a Mridanga Vidwan." Wow. Now my father told me, "I am only looking for you."
Fantastic.
So that happened by the divine grace.
Absolutely.
Then he said, the boy is interested in Mridanga. Why do you start Mridanga? And my first guru is Arabadi Nadeshia. So I started playing Mridanga. I left to Ganjira between 3 and 5. I was just playing, and you will be interested to know. Between the age of 4 and a half or 5, Paramacharya's brother, he took photo of me with a ganjira.
Lovely.
His name is Shivam. Shivam. He had a photo studio in Matsid, Madatatiru. Matsid. He was having a studio known as Shivam Studio.
Oh.
You understand?
Yes.
Shivam Studio. Where he took, when I was four and a half years, with the ganjira, he took a photo. So I was blessed that the first photo was taken by Paramacharya's brother, Shivam. So what happened was, the same day when I started Mridangam, I joined the primary school for my education. Mm-hmm. You understand?
Yes.
The same day, Mridangam started, and my formal education in a primary school opposite, somewhere in the same street, I began. Up in one class. I started this. And then I learned very nearly 7 years of Mridangam under Arabadi Nadeshirwal. And he was a disciple of a great Mahavidwan in Mayavaram, known as Mayavaram Lakshmana Rao. So I learned 7 years, and my arangetram was done at my age of 10 in Kamachi Joseph. And there is a very big temple known as Kalahastiswara Swami Temple, where my debut concert known as arangetram was held when I was 10. And a great musician known as Srinivasa Iyengar, he sang. And another great musician known as Vedarani Ramachandramurti, Vedarani Krishnamurti, played on the violin. And I played Mridangam, and my guru played Ganjira. That happened. And that is the beginning in the Divine Presence Temple of Kalahastiswara Swami. But at the same time, I'm also going to school, passing out, like that. And I was, at the time, then my father wanted to take me to Tanjavur Vaidyanathirwal. Because he told my father, you bring him when he has 9 or 10 or something like that. So we fixed up, he fixed up an appointment, and then another Mahavidwan from Umyavadvaram, known as Umyavadvaram Kodandramiya, he came along with me. They were all contemporaries. Sanjar Vaidyanathiyar, my fourth guru, Rangu Ingar, Kodandramiya, they are all contemporaries. So I went with my father, and I passed out for first form. Then I joined, under my father put up a family with my grandmother Savitri Ammal, and he joined me in Kalyana Sundaram High School, Tanjavur, for second form. I was in first form A, and I was in second form B. Yeah, understand?
Yes.
So, and
Mama. So let's fast forward from here.
Vale, vale. No, I'll tell you. And I went to Tanjavur. I'm repeating it once again. I finished first form and second form in Kumbakonam. First form A section, second form B section, and third form, when I was 12, I went there. And then I studied with my Tanjavur Vaidyanathiyar for 1 year. And the training that Tanjavur Vaidyanathiyar, the Mahavidwan, gave for 1 year, because after that he passed away, I should say it is a very great activity of rhythmic and melodic exercise of all kinds. He gave me everything for mridangam. And I should say, I think even today, remember, if it is 365 days I learned under him, I consider this as 365 years.
Beautiful.
Not one day.
Beautiful.
Like that. He really gave me all great lessons, blessed me that I should be great. So, since he passed away, you listen to me. And then, at that time, my second guru was mentioning about my talents and all that to my third guru, Palghat Manir, who is also a disciple of Tanjavur Vaidyanathiyar. He comes to Tanjavur. So, Tanjavur, my second guru, Vaidyanathiyar, was telling about my tuition with him, my talents, my skill, everything. So he could not hear me because I will be in the morning with my guru, and when I go to school, my third guru will come. Like that, I was missing. But he knows me. He has already told about me. So when my second guru passed away, I stayed away. My father arranged to have further lessons from Palghat Manir. So what really happened was, I was in third forum C in Tanjore. I came to Madras and joined fourth forum in a Ramakrishna Mission, T. Nagar, fourth forum K section, and learned under the great legend Palghat Manir for 1 year. Then, after 1 year, my father shifted me from here to Kumbakonam and gave furthermore training in the art of mridangam under the great and one of the contemporaries of Tanjavur Vaidyanathiyar, Kumbakonam Rangu Ingar, otherwise known as Shakota Rangu Ingar. So, first 7 years with the Aruval Nadesiyar, 1 year with the Tanjavur Vaidyanathiyar, 1 year with Palghat Manir, another 6 years with the Shakota Rangu Ingar, was considered to be one of the greatest mridangam vidwans of that time. So, at that time, I joined Kumbakonam Tamilai School. The Tamilai School produced the greatest avatara person and mathematical wizard, Ramanujam. Ramanujam was he studied there, 1935. So, what happened? Fifth form, sixth form, SSLC, inter college, BA, 6 years. I learned under ரொம்ப இங்கே ஆர்வாள் கும்பகோணம் சாக்கட்டா இங்கே இங்கே ஆர்வாள் அட் த டைம் ஐ வாஸ் ஆல்சோ பிளேயிங் கான்சர்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் ஆல் திட் லேர்னிங் ப்ராசஸ் இஸ் தேர் பர்ஃபார்மிங் ஆல்சோ இஸ் தேர் லைக் தட் ஐ வாஸ் லைக் தட் த மெயின் திங் இஸ் வை ஐ குட் நாட் ரியலி ஐ குட் நாட் ரியலி கோ டு ரியலி மை ஃபாதர் வாண்டட் that I should take medical profession at that time. And I could not go because my mother passed away in 1951. So when I finished SSLC, I had to take some course in Kumbakonam Government College. Anyway, it's a good thing. I took a BA degree in 1955. And then at that time in 1955, Palakkad Mani, my third guru, was in Thandavur. I went to him, generally in the leave, holiday, I will go to him. And then one day he told me, Shivaram, he used to call me Shivaram. Shivaram, you go to Madras and be there, you will really prosper. Like a very, you will be very prosperous in this field. You will become very great and you will have concerts and you can also hear other great vidwans. You'll be very successful, you will become great. He blessed me. Then I came here, and then 1950 onwards, I'm in Chennai, and my uncle, I stay with one of my relatives, distant relatives, one is Engineer Shivaramiyan of Humayalpur. And here, I came as a bachelor, and then from 55, I stayed with my uncle. He is a very great intellectual like my father. He groomed me. And then he told me, you are only playing in the evening concert. But I was playing concerts. Why don't you join law college and then study and take a degree also in the morning? Likewise, what happened was, I joined law college. At that time, one of the greatest votaries of Carnatic music, Justice Anasanarayanan, was the director of legal studies. And they put me in the evening, and there is one manager, Radhakshi, here. He was interested in music, and I approached these two people. Sir, if some concert is going to be there in the evening, I'm put in the evening batch, I cannot play. Why don't you put me in the morning? They said, yes, I will put you. They put me in the morning batch of the law college. So I studied from 10 o'clock to 1 o'clock or 1:30. And in the evening, I will have concert, or in the evening, I will practice. Like that, it is also a divine command that people who are really votaries of Carnatic music, they were there in the law college to help me change the timings of my studies also. Likewise, these are all about my... And the four gurus, the important factor about the four gurus is, when I went from one guru to other guru, the previous guru gave me a lot of blessings and told me, you are going to the greatest guru.
That is very, like that, very important.
Not only that, this is the greatest planning by the grace of God, and I should really be very indebted and thankful to my father for planning this particularly mentorship field for me from the great gurus.
Thank you. Now let's fast forward. So you were practicing law for some time, and you had a great friendship with my great granduncle. Not great granduncle, but a very great person, because he was the associate editor of the Hindu, and he has done so much for our family, and we are blessed to have known him. I was 2 years old when he passed away. I've heard so much about him. So you've been associated closely with the great Raghunath Iyer, and you know, he has had an influence on your life is what you have told me. Could you share a few words about you know, the divine providence that connected you with him, and then what happened in your life?
You know, this great Raghunath Iyer's sister and brother, and her husband, known as Sundaresiyar and his wife, that is Raghunathiyar's sister, that is a brother-in-law of Raghunathiyar. They lived in Dabi Street. They were the clients of my father. So for long time, there is a great friendship and intimacy between my father and Raghunath ji. And my father used to develop his writing in English after reading the editorial of Raghunath ji in Hindu. For a number of years, for several years, he was studying. In fact, he says that he was very much influenced by the writings of Raghunath ji. So, Raghunath ji had a great fancy for my father's English writing.
Lovely.
And then he will say in Tamil, "Oi, doctor, Kashi, இந்த மாதிரி இங்கிலீஷ் டாக்டர் ஒருத்தனை எழுத மாட்டாங்க, நீ ஆர்டிக்கலாம் எழுத, நான் ஹிந்துல போடுறேன் அப்படின்பார். What he says in English, I will tell you. Doctor Kashi, you are very well up in English writing and all that. You are, no doctor will write like you. I really appreciate the language and the diction that you really write. Particularly your language is very powerful. Why don't you write articles for the Hindu? I will publish." So that is beyond. And Raghunath ji had a great admiration for the diagnostic greatness of my father. So the English language of my father is so. Very, he was very much appreciated. And then they were great friends. When I saw that great personality, Hindu Raghunath ji, his initial is N. He wrote Sota verse under the pen name of Vigneshwara. Am I right?
Yes.
Vigneshwara is the pen name.
Yes.
Sota verse.
Yes.
You know what happened? One day, I went and prostrated before him. And then he asked me, "Hey, what are you doing?" Then I replied, "I joined the law college and now studying. He knows that I am playing and all." Then he said, "Hey, Shivarama, I also got BABL. You are also in the law college, you are going to get BABL. I am not a practicing lawyer. I don't want you to practice. I don't want you to become a lawyer. But one thing I tell you, you play mridangam and I bless you, you will be the greatest mridangam vidwan in Karnataka, basically. Bless me."
Amazing.
Long back.
Amazing.
Long back.
How old were you then, Mama?
Probably, all these, I think he was in Mylapore. At that time,
right.
Very near Sai Baba Koil, very near Sai Baba temple, he was there. Mm-hmm. I don't exactly remember whether I met him here or whether I met him in Kumbakonam, I don't know, because I was in law college. I think this would have happened only in Chennai.
Correct.
And you know what happened? Later on, when your auntie's marriage was celebrated in Bangalore, I played mridangam and Shatur Subramanyam, he sang. I played mridangam and then incidentally the great legend Dr. C.V. Raman came there and then I played. And then before the conclusion of the program, they wanted to garland and then your grandfather came. Raghunath ji came and he garlanded all people and he garlanded me. And then I prostrated him. And then he said in Tamil, "Eta, Shivarama, ne periya mahavidwana pettiya me nee. Enna nee periya mahavidwana pettiya me romba sandoshanda da ya aashirvaadam." To be translated in English. Then he put the call and told me, "Hey, Shivaram, I think you have become very great in mridangam. Yeah, they call you as Mahavidwan. I am very happy. Go to further heights. I bless you." And he gave me a lot of blessing that day. Because I cherish all these greatest blessings. But you see, when great people say something, it is prophetic. It is prophetic. It is divine. And you let it happen. That is the faith in which I am working. So, when I asked him on the occasion, he's a jolly man. At least he is a jolly man with me. I asked him, Mama, I want your books. I want to read your books. Then he asked me, Enda, na English illa puriyumada?
And I can tell you, many of the words he uses, I have read it. I really don't understand. You need a dictionary.
And you know, to translate it, I asked him, Mama, I want a set of books from you. Then he told me, Hey, Shivaram, can you really decipher my writing? You cannot. Will you? Then I told him, Mama, whether I understand or not, these are invaluable books I want to keep. I will really read and get the meaning. Then he told me, no, I'm giving you with blessings. He gave me some books and all that. So the connection, at that time, I think, in the marriage, your father's Upanayanam was conducted.
Exactly, correct. You're right.
Rajaram's Upanayanam was there. I still have the photo with me. And see, at every turn of your life, if you are going to get the blessings of the great people, what more do you really need in life?
This
will support you and this will take you to greater heights. But the only thing is, if you are going for greater heights, you must remember with humility that you have been blessed by these people and you are reaching that stage.
Very true. Which
and
is
my father,
Mama, right in the beginning, I mentioned that you have played a very, very important and significant role in my spiritual discipline. Okay, whether it is the Sandhya Vandanam or, you know, the meditation, the pranayama, all those things have really and profoundly impacted my life. And I have to thank you because every time you came home, you would sit me down along with my brother and say, listen, please do this. It's going to benefit you. So, you know, I'm very, very thankful to you for that. I will always be thankful to you for that. And I'm following your advice diligently.
No, I tell you. So, along this, my father used to tell me, when I get any award and all this, I'll tell you later on. I'll tell you the illustration later, but the thing is, my father will always tell me, Shivarama, yes, everything is coming to you by the grace of God. I will tell him, by your grace, then he will say, by the grace of God is coming to you. Don't think about all these things. Go further to further heights. Work. Don't remember all these things. Go to that. So, that is the motivation with which I have started my life. My life is still going on. And the same motivation I am giving to my family members. And I'm always giving the same motivation to other family members who are so dear to me, like your family. Because Paramacharya, he tells the people, when he was addressing people, he used to say that Avatar Purusha, I'm telling you all these great things. If at least in the public of thousands of people, if 100 people is going to really practice what I do, that is sufficient for me. That 100 will become 1,000. 1,000 will become 10,000. And lakh, million and all that. Likewise, do say the same thing. And I have been telling you for a number of occasions, but on one particular occasion, when I mentioned this, the spark has really touched the heart and the fire has begun to glow. And then you really felt the glow and the heat came. When the heat comes, you are really going towards the track of great things. I want to do this, Mama told me. So if you keep telling all these things, someday something will strike you. That will be the opening for a great show of philosophical approach, enlightenment, improvement, and all round greatness that will happen to one's life and mission.
Thank you. You know, while on that topic, just to put this on record, when Raghunath Iyer was writing the Ramayanam, he was translating the Ramayanam to English. The last visit, you know, I hear this from the family grapevine, my mother, my father, he had visited the great Paramacharya, and Paramacharya told him, in the Ramayana ezhudhuriye adu seekram mudichiru appdin sollittu Paramacharya. So basically he told him, you are writing, you are translating the Ramayanam to English, please finish it soon. He said that, and he took my grand uncle and dropped him off at his car when he had visited him. So he came back and he followed Paramacharya's advice, and within a few months, I think, I don't know the exact timeline, he finished writing the Ramayana and he passed away. So Paramacharya knew that this was going to happen, because, you know, he's a great soul, of course. So this is something that when you say the blessings of great people is something that is very, very important in our lives, and we shouldn't take our success seriously, but we should continue to pursue excellence. I think this is one story that we have to put on record.
Why I'm telling you, the great blessings, because I did not know all these things. My four gurus blessed me to such an extent. I never knew as a boy, even before about 20 years, even before 20, 25 years, I never knew all the facts. But one fact, I began, somebody told me, fact after fact, incident after incident, somebody came and told me, your first guru told about you, your second guru told about you, third guru told about you, fourth guru told about you. Like that, I think they have blessed me in the sense, what can I say? I can only quote, the greatest bard of Carnatic music, the Avatara Purushan, and the Mahan, Thyagaraja Swami. He said in one of the songs, when so many people, bhaktas, he was in Tiruviyar, which is one of the end of the South India. It's a gramam in those days. And so many people, devotees are coming all over from India to worship Thyagaraja. And Thyagaraja says, why are you coming and worshipping me? Rama sent all of us here to worship you. Then he says, in the Sikhiti, Dasarade ni Ranavtipana Tarama, he says, hey Dasarade, hey Rama, you are sending all these people, you are making me great in all the places. All the people are coming and worshiping me. I am deeply indebted to you. I will always remain a debtor because you are always sending all the people. Likewise, when I came to know about the blessings, not only the blessings of my gurus, great people like my father, Raghunath Iyer, very great people, and very great personalities in Carnatic music, who really prophesied about my future activity and greatness in the field of Mridangam and Carnatic music. And when I'm hearing all these things, I only think probably the cumulative effect of these great blessings and benign blessings of the great people, they are standing me in good stead. So I am not the reason for any enjoyment, or I cannot have any ego. I am not prepared to, because my philosophy is always say go to ego. My philosophy.
Absolutely. And your humility is amazing, Mama, because you have really achieved the pinnacle. Hello, can you hear me?
I'm hearing you, but the thing is, the more I hear about all the blessings of the great people, the more I think how indebted I am to these great people who are with me. So they are not there, but I see they are within me. When I play Mridangam, I still feel, now I really greatly feel, I am not playing Mridangam. They are inside me. They activate me. They play through me. I am only an instrument.
Brilliant.
In their hands. So, when there is any credentials or greatness that is always being bestowed on me, my father told me, revert all these things to the great people. So it will go like to them. It is like putting money into the bank and build up the capital. And you only take the interest from the bank. The capital will remain there in crores. And for your family sustenance, you will take only interest. So put it back to the holy feet of the great people and Almighty, and the blessings will come. So this is a question of cycle. Cycle is coming from there. Yeah. Put the cycle like this. It will go there and it will come back like that. It's only like this. So, and moreover, the more I really feel and practice and motivate people, I only feel how great is the ocean of music and rhythm, where so many unknown things are there. So, is this life enough to really master this great art?
Lovely.
So, you have to take several lives to really master. But the thing is, you should always take the boon from God. God, in my next birth, I should be much better player in Mrigam, know much more subjects. Like that, if you take many, many births, probably we can really have, it is like, you can only touch the fringe of the iceberg. The iceberg is big, but only the fringe you are touching. And I give you another thing. So many people asking me, sir, will you see it? YouTube.
Hmm.
I tell them, I am not seeing because I don't have any mobile. People ask me, why you don't have mobile? Hmm. I say jokingly, I am still mobile.
not like all of us.
You know what happened? I tell the people, I am not really looking at YouTube. I'm in a tunnel. I am inside a tunnel where I see a light. I am following the light. It is like a mirage. The nearer I go, the farther it goes. And when I look back, I am crossing so many people. And that is it. So this light is taking me far away. In such a case, at least the tip of the iceberg is the opening that is given to me to see the greatness of this ocean of music and melody and rhythm. But in the process, you are causing so many people. And when I went to 1962 to USA, in New York Times, particularly in New York, I read an article in New York. That is my first visit from South Side, 1962. I got New York Times, and that is a proverb. It is still there in my mind, in my heart. That is written. Hey, in the life, you are crossing in the ladder of fame and name, so many people, and you are going up. And you turn to your compatriots and have a smile on them. In case there is a fall, they will support you.
Correct.
So this I read in 1962, and it is still fresh in me. So when you cross so many people, bow them.
Correct.
And then revere them, do the namaskar, and then proceed. And such a long time as God wills, you will proceed. But the thing is, the more you are going inside, the more you know how shallow your knowledge is in music and rhythm. That is, That is why music is very much akin to, and it is being described as Sangeetha Ratnagaram. Sangeetha Ratnagaram, Ratnagaram is always ocean. Sangeetha Mahodati, Tala Samudram, Laya Samudram, like that they call. So, in the sands of time, if you really print your footprints and leave it for many people, you become an immortal man. A mortal man can become immortal, but to achieve immortality, what you have to do is your goal. And there is another thing is, you can build the castles in the air, but you have to lay the foundations below. And another one, these are all the things that was told by my uncle when I was very small, 1955. He mentored me. And then Shivarama learned all these things. And then he said, sky is the limit. Go beyond the sky. Spend. You take your sleeping hours and work for the goal. When the whole world is sleeping, you be awakeful. You will achieve greatness. Like that, so many people have told me all these things. And then I read very recently, and I have put up this proverb in my house. Man does not become old. That is the proverb. Man does not become old. When he stops growing, he becomes old.
Correct.
Man does not become old, but when he stops growing, he becomes old. So, and for me, there is no generation gap.
I know that. And your sense of humor, you make us all laugh every time you come home.
No.
We have such a blast.
No, I'm telling you why. I have moved with people. The only thing is, when there is so much of change in environment, society, family, you should be always like a bamboo. You should be like a bamboo, where if there is going to be a blow of air, the bamboo will be like this pliability.
Flexibility, yes, correct.
That if we are not going to be flexible, we can never shine. And likewise, I am a great devotee of Bhagavan Ramana by Maharshi, because he says that you cannot give advice to anybody because you are not perfect.
Correct.
You are only in the process of getting perfection. When you are not perfect, how can you really say that you can preach to anybody and say that you have to do this? So, know what you are. Know thyself. Improve yourself. Make yourself holy. First of all, you realize all these things. That is why, for some years, I am not giving any advice to anybody. When somebody asked me in Bangalore, what is your advice to youngsters? I told him, I have not improved myself. I am shaping myself. I want to really become perfect. When I am not perfect, how should I give my advice to youngsters? On the contrary, the youngsters are very intelligent. They are knowing every subject under the sun. In fact, I am learning more from the youngsters.
Correct.
And I am learning more from, rather than giving anything from me. So these are all the things that I am having in my life.
You've been very humble indeed. But then I want you to say a few words about your practice regimen. Okay, so when there are a lot of people who want to pursue excellence, okay, and you are a person who has achieved, you know, phenomenal excellence in your field, despite the fact that you don't wear it on your sleeve. How should people go about pursuing excellence? Could you say a few words about that? What your practice regimen is even today? Because I know for a fact that even today you practice like you did so many years ago.
See, the thing is, you cannot have too many irons in the fire. I will tell you about my life. I studied law. After law, I went to Master of Law in the University of Madras. It was a 2-year course. I only did for 1 year. Then I left it. Then this particular simile, an example came to me. When you shoot a rocket and it goes up, the rocket is being supported by booster rockets. It goes Milky Way, it goes through a gravitational pull, goes to Milky Way, and then when it reaches orbit, all the booster rockets will fall. Likewise, in my life, all the other booster rockets, like law and other things, they fell. So my goal of Murdingam artist, it went up and it is there in the orbit now. So if you want to set goal, as I told you, my life is full of divine blessings. When I was there, I was being given the mentorship by the greatest gurus. I had the unique opportunity of a great father supporting my art. That means he will go to any extent of supporting me. And when I came to Chennai in 1955, from 1955 I'm here, when I was with my uncle, even in Kumbakonam I used to practice for several hours. When I joined law college, you know what happened? That when I was practicing Murdangam, one gentleman, he was a great musician, he heard my Murdangam Nada came. Who are you? From where you came? I am Umiyalpuram Sriram. Oh, you are Umiyalpuram Sriraman. I know you. I have heard about you. I know that you are famous. This is your uncle. And he took a lot of interest in me. His name is Kalyana Kurti Mahadeva. And I learned vocal music from him. He became my guru. And he considered me much above his own sons. So whenever he is free in the morning, if it is going to 10 o'clock, he will come there. Hey, take Murdangam. I will sing for you 2 hours. So likewise, he was singing for 10 years continuously without expecting any return from me except my bhakti. You know, when I see him in anywhere I see him, even the street, I will not mind. I will immediately prostrate before him, even if it is going to be street. Such is the greatness of that. And when I stayed with my uncle, from the morning to night, so many great vidwans like P.S. Narayan Sami, E.R. Krishnan, Palaka Subramaniya, and then Ramani, Chengalpattu Ranganathan, so many people come. So when I started Murdangam in Mylapore, I was doing the same thing in Kumbakonam, the same continued here. And the great atmosphere and the ambience were provided to me by God. And without expecting anything, they will sing. Everybody will sing for 1 hour, and I will practice for 8-9 hours. So like that, at the same time, I must do my education. And I had no other hobby. Only this. That is,
focus.
The thing is, God gives you many opportunities. But the thing is, when you sacrifice certain things, he says, you are meant for this. Hmm. You understand what I mean?
Yes, yes.
You understand what I mean?
Sacrifice is crucial.
No, no, wait. That is no. He will give you many avenues to choose from. But if you choose the right avenue and sacrifice everything, then he says, that is also by his grace. But he tests you. So he blessed me with all these things. So every day, there will be very nearly 78 hours of my breathing practice. And in addition to that, in the seat where I said, the people also liked my Mrudangam and musical session. When there is not one day my practice, they'll ask, Dennaya, Shivaram sir, no practice today. Likewise, practice. And it became my second habit, my second nature. Or I can call, it became my first nature, not second nature. So I became one with Mrudangam. Mrudangam became one with me, and that is Advaita Bhava. That is Advaita Bhava. And moreover, if you set a goal, and the main problem at that particular time was the music field was very greatly like Palakkad Maniyar, like Payani Subramanian Pillai, like Muruga Bodhi, like T.K. Amurthy, and so many others. So if you want to break and make a mark, that is something very, very difficult because people will never receive you in the same stature in which they are having you, others. Right. You understand?
Yes, yes.
So, how to break, how to make a name, how to create a vani, how to be appreciated by the same great people. These are all very great responsibilities for me. So, by the grace of God, I created on the foundations of my guru my own body, known as Umayavaram Sivaraman body. And I began playing. That was greatly appreciated by all people. In addition to that, very great musicians like Ariyakudi, Shammangudi, Madhuramaniyar, GNB, Maharaja Vishwanathiyar, T.R. Mahalingam, and then Chambai, Chavadeya, Rajamanikamalai, Papa Vangat Ramiya. I cannot, by innumerable great people, and other people like Sathu Subraniyar, Mayavar Rajamayar, Sri Pasadi, T.M. Thyagarajan, Ramnath Krishan, M.D. Ramanathan, K.V. Narayanan, so many people, I began accompanying all people. They liked me. And my own gurus and other great people in the field, they liked my bani. The rasikas, that is the audience, they liked me. And in fact, one particular magazine, which is very popular in Tamil, it wrote about my rise. Your rocket has come. Now it is that the rocket is going farther. And the rocket is Umayavaram Sivaraman. That was the writing in those days. So like that, but the thing is, improve on what we have already gained, because you have to become greater, and you have to become greatest, and you have to become a Mahavidwan, and you have to become a legend, and you have to become immortal.
Correct.
When the gradations are there, you have to work.
There is no simple path. So divine grace touches you when you put in the effort.
No, there is no stopping.
Yeah.
There is no stopping. And by the grace of God, all the opportunities came to me. Not only from Karnataka, from Hindustani. I began playing with the greats like Ravi Shankar, all great people like Krishna Maharaj. And then I had my first visit in 1962 with United States with Balachandar. Very great. It was a great awakening for Carnatic music. And then I joined Talavadiya Kacheri. I was invited to Rajwadiya Kacheri with great musicians like Briju Maharaj, Krishna Maharaj, Kalla Rakha, Santa Prasad. They are all great names. And they loved me. You know, on one occasion, Kishan Maharaj used to call my mridangam. He used to call me, yeah, can you give chopper? I like that. No. He said, Shivaramji, I've got swar de diye. For the chopper, he said, swar. Santa Prasad, his fingers, you know, it was like, you know, rockets. Nobody can be near him. But I played 15 concerts. At the end of the 15th concert, he bodily lifted me. And then he said, nobody can really aspire to get any applause before me. In the field, you only did it. And you did it for 15 times. Or 15, I really admire you. You are the greatest. And he said in Hindi, because he will never speak English. Right? I memorized what he said, that it happened in Hyderabad. He had a lot of blessing, I mean, very great affection. He said, Madangam, Bada Kala Kari, both respect regarded. Aapka Guruji, Palakalpani Ji hai, Fir, Sivaraman Ji hai, Fir, Nahi hai. This is what he told me. So, I played this game and then I joined so many jazz, fusion, all groups. And I am still a member of a very great group known as Aka Moon. That is in Belgium. Fabrice Castle, Michel. They are all great artists. Stephen Gallen. Stephen Gallen, particularly drumming, he is as very sweet like Bharang. He considers me Master Shivaram, my guru, Master Shivaram. So I'm there. So this gave me a lot of opportunities to shine in all the fields. And what happened was, same way, my research work started almost about 50 years back. And when I started, I thought, music, you can have demonstration. How are you going to interest the people in rhythm? Then it became musical rhythm. Rhythm became musical and music became rhythmical. So there was a wedlock of melody with harmony and harmony with melody. So it started and I introduced so many things. I told the people in several global cities in India, all over, about the greatness of music, the overtones. I studied C.V. Raman. I studied about Ramakrishna, Professor Ramakrishna, so many books. And I was very fortunate to have the collaboration with me even today till and tomorrow also. One of the greatest scientists of India is Dr. T. Ramaswamy, another great scientist, M.D. Naresh. They are collaborating with me. And IIT Chennai is collaborating with me also in the percussive transcription of percussive syllables on computer. Mm-hmm. So with all that, we have lately produced a great work after 100 years. And the blessing is when the vice president, the honorable vice president, when he released the book in Chennai, the great thing is that it was the day of C.V. Raman. When I gave the lecture, after so many years in Music Academy, along with Ramaswamy and Naresh, it was the day of Ramanujam. So the great two legends, this is all God's will. Likewise, I introduced Fiberglass Bharatangam. Later on, I introduced glass Bharatangam, and I had a great this video presentation of Mridangam lessons and all that for 22 hours, known as Mridanga Chintamani, Mora and Korve and all that. And the latest book is there. It is there in the market. And it's a wonderful book, really, after C.P. Raman. This is a contribution. Why I'm telling you, at every stage, when I play, somebody is coming to me, something is happening. Why is this happening? Why all these things are happening? Is it because of my samarthyam? Is it because of my brain? No. Some light, some cosmic energy is guiding everything. Hey, you are there to do this work. I have meant this for you. You have to fulfill all these things. This is the work that I have done for you. This work I am doing through you. Do that. Don't leave it. Likewise, why I'm telling you, you have to sacrifice. When a man sacrifice, I tell you, offers came from the Wesleyan University to appoint me as the professor of Mridangam as early as 1963, 64, 65, 66. I should have gone there. Now, I should be only a citizen of the United States and my whole family should be there. At that time, I was building my career. My father is here with me. What happened? That is the yearning of dollars. Not only dollars. Beyond that, you are the first eminent artist from India to go abroad and teach Mridangam. This is the avenue. So, it is like a cat on the wall. The wall was American visit. The cat was from Shivaram. So, the cat was sitting on the wall. What really happened was, I asked my father, what is your advice? I used to call my father, Mama. Mama, what is your advice? He asked me, will you listen to me? I told him, I am only listening to you and not to anybody else. Then he said, you are building up your career here. I want that you should improve on it and make a very great name here. Or if you want to worship the dollar, you can go there.
Brilliant advice.
And he said in Tamil, the dollar is like a ghost, bosom. The dollar is like a ghost or bosom. Between the two, you have to choose. My idea is that you should be here. And they offered me 3 or 4 times. And they waited me for this year, next year, next year, next year. Then I told them, I am not coming. I refused the job. When I sacrificed that, something came here for me.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Likewise, when John Higgins, when I accompanied him, he was there in York University. He joined York University. He said, Shivaram sir, you must come there. You must be with me in the music department. I am offering you the post of professorship. I would have gone to Canada for York University. I told them, I am not coming. I refuse all this. So, a big sacrifice when you make in your life. By the time had I gone there, I would have made a lot of money.
Correct.
But the thing is, lot of money, you want lot of money or immortal name? Money will come, but not name and fame. So, somewhere or other, I listened to my father. I thought it is prophetic. I refused the 2 assignments, but I thanked them for calling me. Likewise, in my life, you have to sacrifice certain things. If you don't sacrifice, you can never come in your life.
True.
And another things, I apply 2 economic principles in life. The economic principle of supply and demand. When the demand is there, you have to when the supply is inferior, you have to reduce the demand. Supply, demand, supply and demand theory, you have to apply in art, in life and everything. Other thing is increasing returns and decreasing returns. When there is going to be great listening, you have to stop somewhere so that next time they can come with a fresh mind to listen to you. For example, if you want to really eat 4 idlis or 4 dosais, stop with the 2.5, take water. As Paramacharya says, fill up your stomach with 50% and fill up your stomach with 25% of water. The next 25% will be for gas production and digestion.
Correct.
Likewise, if you apply all the principles, not only that, the other principle is when the people want more, when they really want more, before that you have to stop. If that is the case, you will sustain the interest with the audience. They will come to you, oh, what is going to happen next concert? They will come. You should not show everything, but you should have everything. You will have the vase with you. But the thing is, when to use, when not to use, how to use. That is why I give very special importance for the particular word, why. W-H-Y. I thought why it is important. Then I remembered, I went into introspection. W is, what is the problem that represents W? H, how the problem is solved. And why the problem is there. They make the group that becomes why is very important. In life also, why should I do it? Why should I refuse it? Why I should have not refused it? Why I did it? So more than what, why comes. So why is important.
I don't know, you know, I'm so blessed because I'm a Carnatic music illiterate, but I love you dearly. When I asked you, you never asked why, and you accepted to do this interview. I think I'm completely honored, Mama. Thank you so much.
Great.
And now...
No, 1 minute. Sujay, you will have to really withdraw the statement of illiterate in music. Because every human being is a spark of the divine. And you should be a good rasika. A good rasika need not be a scholar. He need not be a literate. Why I'm telling you? I'll give you an example. When Rajaratnam Pillai was playing in somewhere in Tanjore district, in those days, there is big gas light for temple festival, gas light. You understand?
Yes.
And the gas light fellow, he put down the gas light because Rajaratnam Pillai was playing, he began to play Thodi. And then the gas light fellow, he told somebody, hey, Rajaratnam Pillai is playing Thodi. You know, this reached the Rajaratnam Pillai is here. He came and hugged this fellow. And hey, you know Thodi. Your job is only gas lighter. You are only doing the job. But your jnana is different. You are different, but your jnana is different. So, your family is full of rasikatvam. You are all great rasikas of music, great votaries of music. So, you are a literate in
appreciation. So, which is why next I'm going to move and request you to play a super fast Tani for me.
So, you are a literate in music, you are a literate in business, you are a literate in joint family, you are a literate in your family. Not only that, you are a literate for friendship. So I hold you in a different esteem level. So
thank you, Mama.
You are a good rasika. You are Are you happy with my...
I have had a fantastic time. I've loved it.
The thing is, I will... My mission, there is only one thing I want to do in my life. I will tell you. You know, Robert Browning is one of the greatest poets. He wrote in one poem known as Grammarian Swindle. In that he says, "Oh God, whatever that I was not able to do in this life, give the bone that I will try to do all these things, at least in my next birth." That is what he says. Likewise, if it's all, I'm going to be reborn. I pray to God, I should be a Mridangam Vidwan and I should be a better Mridangam Vidwan in my next birth, realizing the greatness of Mridangam and the nuances and the great qualities of Mridangam. Mridangam stands for in the field of Carnatic music. And the last one is, my wish is, I am pursuing Nada. Nada. In the metaphysical world, it is, I want to tell you before I play, knowledge is not jnana. Knowledge is different, jnana is different. Sound is different, nada is different. I am pursuing nada because Mridangam is a nada vadya. Though it comes under percussion, the level, because that is why I call Mridangam the king of percussion, the queen of melody.
Beautiful.
That is why I call Mridangam like that. So, Mridangam is a nadavadya. It is not a time marker as people like. It is something superb. Without Mridangam, no concert will be there and nothing can embellish without Mridangam.
Absolutely.
Nothing can embellish without Mridangam. Mridangam is supreme. That is why Nandikeshwara is the presiding deity of that.
Yes.
My wish in this life is that I should experience Nada and there should be a concert where there should be a full house. I open my Mridangam, tune Mridangam, put Rava on the left side and the main artist is there, full house, and I give one chop, plong, with that. That nada, saturated, we should cover, saturate the whole hall. And the audience should say, oh, we have heard it. We have come only for this. We don't want any more. They should get up. I also get up. Then we close the show.
Fantastic.
That is the nada that is going to envelop the whole world, for which I'm trying, and I will try forever. But anyway, Sujay, I'm very, very touched. I won't say thankful because Ramana Bhagavan said, don't say thank you. Say Parama Sandosham. Thank you is from the lips. Parama Sandosham is from the heart. If you feel Rumba Sandosham, it will come in the heart. Then I Rumba Sandosham in talking with you and sharing my heart and feelings, my sentiments, everything with you. Keep it very safe. Even though you are going to put it for some channel, definitely I think you will preserve this and then you can give me also a copy of that, which I will preserve. And I'll give it to my family. Now,
Mama, yenakum parama sandosham.
Adanale,
from the bottom of my heart,
I tell my namaskarams to your grandmother. Tell my blessings to all your family members because I love your family. You are, if at all I can say, it is my family in Bangalore. It is your family in my love.
Exactly. You said it, Mama. You said it. I have no more words to add to that because you've said it brilliantly. Thank you. Thank you, Salokudade. Parama Sandosham bought from the bottom of my heart. So,
give me some time.
Yeah.
I will Sure, Mardangam.
Now I will turn off this video and then we can restart it.
You are happy now.
Very happy.
Very good.
I'm very happy.
I want to sing one thing and then we'll finish.
Okay.
This is in English. Be happy, be jolly, be cheerful. Be happy, be jolly, be cheerful. What I'm going to play is in Aditala, one Kalai, I'm going to present my Mardangam solo.